even at 2 balls and 2.
And man, did he bang it. Just didn't keep it fair. Hustle the heater.
Heading out toward shallow right. Gwynn has to come in a few steps, but he has it for out number Gorias. Hit hard on the ground at first. And a good effort. Into the box now. Trevor Brown on a swing, and he popped him up. Off to the left in foul territory. Prado is over, and he tucks it away for the second out.
Batting four, the designated hitter, Adam Duvall.
Standing in, Adam Duvall. Two out with the man at first. There goes the runner. So it's on to the bottom of inning number one. No score. Here's Eric Sogard. Tries to drag his way on here, but now he's behind 1-2. Pitch on the way. And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. Count holds at 1-2. Here's another 1-2. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
I think he had his mind made up. He was swinging the bat and trying to protect before the ball even left the pitcher's hand. That pitch wasn't even close. He would have needed a flagpole to hit that one.
In now, Michael Fish. And that's going to be high, 2-2 now. One out, nobody on. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now. Matt Joyce waits on deck. Ready to deliver the full count pitch. Here's a pop-up now. Blanco is there for it. And he makes the catch for the second out.
Batting third, designated hitter, Matt Joyce.
Here's Matt Joyce now. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first. Here's the 1-1 now to Joyce. A good knee-high changeup taken for a strike. Two out, nobody on. In now, Adam Duvall. Outside, 2-1.
Well, it's 2-1 now, and we haven't seen a fastball from him in this at-bat yet. As a hitter, you've probably got to sit on that right now.
To 2-2 now.
Back-to-back sliders away. Now I think you have to think about running something hard in. Not a good idea to throw a good hitter the same pitch 3 times in a row.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. And that one stayed up a little high. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Now a swing and a chopper foul right at home plate. finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out. Another strikeout for him on the mound, and boy, is it fun to watch him go about his business.
No doubt, Matty. He's one of my favorites, mostly because of his stuff. You know, he can absolutely dominate on any given day because of what he offers up there. It's just nasty. There aren't many hitters that like to see this guy on the mound.
Stepping in now, Brandon Hicks. And a fastball misses there, ball four.
Batting sixth, center fielder, Brandon Hartley.
Coming to the plate now, Brandon Hartley. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. Now a throw over and a dive, but he's back in there. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses one and two.
Backdoor breaking ball just missed right there. It's such an effective pitch if you can hit the corner with it, but no dice this time.
No score here as we play inning number two. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
Batting seventh, right fielder.
Striding Lewis into the box, Basic. Lewis Basic. Ready with the one and two. Hit on the ground to short. Sogard is there, and an underhanded throw is in time for out number three. So it's no runs, no base hits, no errors, and one man left on base. We'll go to the bottom half of inning number two, and we are tied 0-0. Here's C.J. Cron now. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And he misses 2-1. Set to deliver on 2-1. And he swings on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Here's the pitch on 2-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
Boy, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, a high piece of cheese swung at and missed. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
Standing in now, number 21. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Bottom of the second here with no score. Changeup gets him out in front for strike two.
Well, that changeup right there sets up a lot of things. Now the count's 2-2. He can come back in with a fastball, and it's going to look like it's moving a little bit better. Or he can go back to that changeup.
And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. And the pitch. And that's lifted the other way out to left. Under it is the left fielder, two gone.
Batting sixth, third baseman, Martin Prado.
Martin Prado now. He'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Bases are empty here with two men out. And that's upstairs, running the count to 3-1.
Three ball count right now. This looks like the best chance of getting a base runner on so far.
Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Hartley is in pursuit. He's got it, a great running play, and that'll retire the side. At the plate, Andres Blanco. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. And the payoff pitch is chopped foul at home plate, so we'll do it again. Still 3-2. Once again, a 3-2. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
And that's what you want from your leadoff hitter. Show some great patience and discipline, making the pitcher labor to start the game. The result is a leadoff walk and a chance to make some early noise.
Into the box now, Juan Arias. Fastball called strike, 1-2. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. A double play ball to second. 4-6-3, and they turn the double play.
How about it?
Hey, it's hard to do anything with a pitch like that that's below the zone. And if you do do anything with it, most of the time, this will be the result, a double play on a good pitch down in the zone.
Into the box, number 22. And a first pitch swing. He hits a fly ball to left center. And he dives to make a spectacular catch. What a play there to end the inning. Worth a second look here as this is a beauty to end the inning. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. Stepping in, Tony Gwynn, 7, 8, and 9 to start the home third.
Not much going on offensively so far for these guys. 6 up, 6 down. We'll see if the bottom part of the lineup can get something going.
Well, the home crowd seems a little restless, so I'm sure they'd appreciate it. Two and two count. Here it comes. Tried to stay back on the changeup there, but this is chopped foul at home plate. Ready with another 2-2. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first out.
Batting 8. Left fielder. Grant.
Striding in. Green. Grant Green. Get his first opportunity in this one. And he struck him out as well. So the bottom of the order providing little resistance here, and there are two away.
Hey, anytime a pitcher locates a fastball on the inside corner, it's going to be a tough pitch to hit. That one was spot on, and he had no answer for it.
In now, Carlos Perez. Here's a called strike on the curveball, 1-2. A swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate.
Boy, that's a good pitch. Changeup way off the plate with two strikes. I love it.
And a jam shot here as this is sent towards second. Hicks is right there. Throw in time and the side is retired. Make it 9 straight here to start the ball game. On to the fourth now in game number one. And we are tied 0-0. Ready for another chance? Didi Gregorius. He reached on a single in his first try. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
Well, they haven't been able to scratch a run across
now
yet.
Batting.
So maybe this walk will jumpstart their offense a little
Trevor Brown.
Striding in once again, Trevor Brown. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Nobody out, runner on first. And boy, that misses as well. It's back-to-back walks to start out the inning.
Well, they've struggled offensively in this one so far, but after that walk, they've got runners at first and second and look ready to make a little noise. Just need a big hit now.
Digging in to try it again, Adam Duvall, 0 for 1 for him here in this one. And now a left-hander will start to get ready in the bullpen. And that misses, 2-1.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be aggressive. You can pretty much count on a pitcher. He's trying to get back in the strike zone. And with two guys on base right here, it's time to grip it and rip it.
First and second here with nobody out. On the ground to second base. This could be two. Here's Sogard for one. On to first, a double play.
Oh, that's a rally killer right there. They were in great shape with two on and nobody out. But the double play is the last thing you want in that situation. Just a runner at third now, but there's two outs.
Standing in now, Brandon Hicks. Hit down the line at first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. A couple of walks, but no damage. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Eric Sogard back to the top of the lineup as they're still looking for their first base runner in this one.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've yet to figure this guy out on the mound. He's looked great so far.
He has, but we'll see if this second trip through the order changes anything.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments these hitters are able to make in the middle innings of this game.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Moving under it, basic. He's got it one away.
Now batting, center fielder, Michael Fish.
Digging in for his second at-bat, Michael Fish comes into this at-bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number 4. Pitch popped up, and he'll put this away for the second out.
Now batting, but designated hitter. Matt Joyce.
Here's Matt Joyce now. Two away in the inning, and Dan, it looks like this could be another 1-2-3 inning for him.
Yeah, he has really found a groove on the mound, and it's been impressive to watch. It'll be interesting to see how long he can keep this dominance up.
Here's the 1-1 now to Joyce. And he jumps at a changeup, a swing and a miss.
That's a good changeup. Got him to swing early in it. Now you got him set up. You can go back with the hard fastball or double it up with another changeup.
Here's the 1-2 delivery. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now.
Wow, fastball up and in. I'm not sure it was intended to be that far up and that far in, but message sent, beware.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. And he holds off on the breaking ball, so the count runs full.
Hey, that's a good job right there. Very rarely see pitchers double up where they go a pitch inside. Normally, they'll go back outside, but he followed that up with another pitch on the inside part of the plate.
And he comes back with a fastball. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Adam Wilkes is going to take over here in inning number 5, so it'll be a bullpen game from here on out.
Adam Wilkes.
Digging in, Brandon Hartley. He's 0 for 1 thus far.
And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate. Here's another 2-2. In front of the changeup there as this is chopped foul at home plate.
Well, that was a pretty good swing right there. Tough changeup. Back-to-back changeups, he fouls it off. Now you get the pitch you want, because I can't see him throwing another changeup right here.
And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
The right fielder, number 32, Lewis, Basic.
Now at the plate, Lewis, Basic, 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Bases are empty, one man out. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. Hitters count now. Here's the 2-1. And that one right down Main Street.
Wow, not sure what you're looking for right there, but that one was pretty much middle, center cut. Tough pitch to take.
All even at 2-2. Here it is. And this is swung on and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the fifth.
Third baseman, number 4. Andres Blanco.
Now at the plate, Andres Blanco. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike 2. Set to deal on 2-2. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Swing and a flare hit toward right. And that's in there. Base hit.
That's just really good hitting. Look, I like the decision. 3-2 changeup. Most guys are not going to hit that ball. He located and made his pitch, but he just got beat by a good hitter.
Into the box now, Juan Arias. And this is in the air down the left field line and into foul territory. And they can't run it down. A runner on first with two away. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. Two and one. Swing and a little blooper to center. Basic moving in. He makes the play. A fine running catch to get the first out of the inning.
Now batting, number 21.
At the plate, number 21 comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game. Here it comes on 1-1. On the ground to third. Throw in time at first for out number 2. A look at our line score to this point, and I'm almost certainly jinxing things by pointing it out, but it's worth mentioning that zero in the hit column through two outs here in the fifth. Coming to the plate now, Martin Prado. This guy's still looking at a zero in the hit column. Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. Grounded back up the middle. And there's their first hit of the game.
A lot of base hits up the middle. Set your sights up the alleys and try to take it back up the middle hard like you did right here. Nice job.
Tony Gwynn.
Into the box, Tony Gwynn, a swinging bunt to the mound. So they do get their first hit, but their first run will have to wait as the inning is over. So put another zero on the board as they've been held scoreless through five. Five innings complete, and we still have no score. Ready once again, number 22. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Hit out towards second. Scooped up. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
Hey, now not a lot you can do with that pitch. Up. That fastball just ate him up inside and gets the soft grounder for the out.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Didi Gregorius. It was a walk in his last trip. Action in the bullpen now as a right-hander begins to throw out there. A fastball here, and this is softly hit and fouled off to the left. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Ani pops it up. And he'll squeeze this one for the second out.
Now batting. Catcher, Trevor Brown.
Ready for another shot now. Trevor Brown. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Swing and a miss. He struck him out with a two-seamer, and the inning is over. So stepping in, Grant Green, 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Looking to fade his first walk. Here it comes. Little chopper back his way. Throw to first is in time for the first out.
The catcher, number 99, Carlos Perez.
Digging in to try it again, Carlos Perez comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Here's the 1-1 pitch. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Now some action out in the bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander begin throwing. Tapper right back to the mound. In time to first, and there are two away.
Now batting, the shortstop, Eric Sogard.
Here's Eric Sogard. He's 0 for 2 with a strikeout in this one. Ball 3 here as that pitch runs way up and in and backs him out of the box here. Now here's the pitch. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. Back here at Angel Stadium of Anaheim. Seventh inning coming up now in game one as we take a look there at our game summary through the first six innings so far. Digging in once again, Adam Duvall. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0 for 2 at this point. from the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Right side. He'll get to this one deep in the hole. Throw in time at first. A nice play in short right for the first out.
Good range showing off into the hole right there. That's not an easy play, but these guys make it look that way sometimes.
In now, Brandon Hicks. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2.
Time to focus here. This game is way too close to be walking, guys, so we'll see if he can make him swing the bat on this next pitch.
Now he gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Another payoff pitch. And a swing and a miss here, so it's a quick two outs to start the seventh.
Center fielder number 9, Brandon Hartley.
Striding in once again, Brandon Hartley. He started out the evening 0 for 2 so far. And now we'll see some action in the bullpen as the lefty starts to get loose. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. He struck him out with a two-seamer, and the inning is over.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the traditional seventh inning stretch.
Your Jack Quezada gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh.
Jack Quezada.
Standing in, Michael Fish. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Changeup gets him out in front for strike two. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand, so they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
Stepping in now, Matt Joyce. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. Set. Here's the 3-1. And this will be nowhere close as his control deserts him here. It's a five-pitch walk.
The hitter was dug in looking for something to hit, but he would have needed a telephone pole to hit that thing way out of the zone.
Ready for another chance? CJ Krohn. It's been an 0 for 2 effort for him to this point. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Hit sharply on the ground. And that finds its way through for a base hit. And with that, the go-ahead runs up to second now with only one away.
Man, that's a nice at-bat. Found himself down 0-2, and he just continues to fight. Fought off pitches, gets a 2-2 count, and gets a base hit.
Standing in now, number 21. And that misses for ball four. So the potential go-ahead run moves over to third now.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that one too much.
Digging in and looking for more, Martin Prado. He's singled in two trips to the plate thus far. Ready with the 1-1. Took something off there as this pitch is in the dirt, but handled quickly behind the plate. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. And that will get down as he delivers a big one here. It's a base hit. One run scores. And the second run will score. That makes it a 2-0 ball game.
Man, to come up late in the game and get two runs driven in to put you ahead in a game that was tied, that is beautiful. Now it's up to the pitcher.
Your attention, please.
So they'll go to the bullpen now, and it'll be the left-hander here to face the upcoming left-handed batter. Into the box now, Tony Gwynn. Fastball not close, and he runs it to two balls and a strike.
Looked like he just tried to do too much with that fastball right there. He overthrew it a little bit. That's pretty much the case when you airmail a fastball like that.
And this one is over, and he works the count back to 2-2. Runners are at first and second with one away. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Now another 2-2. And here's a ball hit in the air. Long run for the left fielder, and they can't run it down. The 2-2 one more time. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. The 2-2 one more time. Neither guy giving in here, and they'll do it again. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Boy, and he just won't go away as he fights off another pitch and hits it foul right at the plate.
This is turning into quite an at-bat. That's five foul balls. He's seeing a lot of pitches.
Oh, on the ground to short. Could this be two? One there. On to first. And talk about doing the job out of the bullpen. One batter, two outs, and the inning is over. So it's two runs on two hits, no errors, and a runner left. Eighth inning coming up. The Bees are out in front, 2-0. Fernando Salas been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 59, Fernando Salas.
Into the box now, Lewis Basic, 0-for-2 on his line thus far. And now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Takes a fastball on the inside corner.
They can't afford to continue to fall back any further. They got to get something going on the offensive side. Somebody's got to step up, give a big hit, maybe even a home run, drop a bunt, do something. But this offense has to get going.
Payoff pitch on its way. Chop fouled over towards the coaching box. Here comes the payoff pitch. That's popped up out towards short right field. And he'll get over to... Oh, it kicks off his glove. How did he do that?
Well, when you're winning a game this late, the last thing you want to do is give the other team some hope, and that's what this error does. They have a base runner and a chance to make some noise now.
Digging in the switch hitter, Andres Blanco. And Dan, what's the plan of attack here for the guy on the mound?
Well, I think they have to go right after him. He's pretty unlikely to take you deep. But if you allow him to get on base, the chances of him scoring and tying this game become a lot greater.
He's ready. Now the payoff pitch. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Another full count pitch home. Hit hard but foul toward first, so he'll come back and line it up again. That's in another base hit. He's 2 for 2. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
That's a tremendous at-bat. Saw a bunch of pitches, saw basically everything he throws, and then got a base hit to right field. Can't write it any better.
Into the box, Juan Arias. A wave and a miss, a tick behind a good fastball. Working for the punch out and the offering. And this one's chopped foul right at home plate.
I like the call for the two-strike changeup. You got to make a better pitch. He got away with one right there.
Again, a 1-2. And this one gets away. So now two men in scoring position.
Man, it was already a dicey situation with two on and no out, and then things get worse with the wild pitch there. So instead of a chance to turn two, they've got runners on second and third, and a base hit will drive in a pair.
Here's the 2-2. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Falling for it, Fish. He's there to make the catch, and here comes the runner from third as this should get him on the board. And that's going to bring in the run from third, and just like that, it's back to a one-run ball game. Brian Morris gets the call as he'll pitch with one gone in the top of the eighth.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Stingers, number 57. Ryan Morris.
Stepping into the box, number 22. It's been a rough go of things at the plate for him so far, but his guys are looking for him to change that right here.
Yeah, nothing better than coming through for the boys in a tight game, Matt, especially when you're kind of due to do something productive.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Good looking sinker on the inside corner.
This is where you got to pitch to the strikeout. Infield's drawn in. You don't want contact. You want to make him swing and miss. Throw the nastiest stuff you have.
Crowd gets up for the 3-2. And he struck him out. And wouldn't this be something if he could work out of this with that one run lead still in check?
It's never a good look to strike out looking, but it's way worse when you do it with a guy in scoring position. Those are the times you really want to see a guy battle and at least put the ball in play. Please.
Now pitching for the
Stingers. So with a left-handed hitter waiting, they'll go to their own left-hander out of the bullpen. In now, Didi Gregorius. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. So one run, one hit, one error, and a runner left on. Home half of the eighth straight ahead. The Bees lead it 2-1. Now in the box, Grant Green. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one.
The catcher, number 99, Carlos.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. Count, it's 3-2. And a left-handed batter waiting on deck, though there's a good shot he might get pulled back. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Throw on to first, two gone.
Now batting.
Game one. The Bees are out in front, 2-1. Back now with the Big A as we get a look there at the great city of Los Angeles. Ninth Your inning set lead. To begin. Number now, 84 is Stingers. On, and he'll take over on the Number mound 84. In relief. At the plate, Trevor Brown, 0-for-2 with a walk for him so far. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Maybe too much break on the slider. 2-1.
Mentality has to be to shrink this strike zone to like the size of a soup can. No reason to swing at a pitcher's pitch.
And he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game.
Well, there's only a one-run cushion now to play with, so he's got to be upset after he walked the leadoff man here. Go-ahead run comes to the plate, and there are no outs. This could be a very interesting inning.
Coming to the plate now, Adam Duvall. He'll be looking for something he could drive into the gap and drive home that tying run from first. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Line toward right center. In there, a base hit. And now they'll have runners at the corners to start off the inning.
Well, that's a big base hit right there. Now you hold him up. You got the tying run at third base. You got no outs. You're sitting in a situation where you might be able to not only score that tying run, but break the inning open.
Standing in now, Brandon Hicks. Half swing here, but it won't matter. It's strike three called anyway, and that's out number one.
You know, I'm not quite sure how that strikeout would be scored, looking or swinging. He tried to check his swing, but I'm pretty sure the home plate umpire was ringing him up regardless.
Stepping in now, Brandon Hartley. Tap down the line. That goes foul, so he stays alive with two strikes. Now another 1-2. Nope. And a neck-high fastball that time.
No doubt. Some saves come easier than others, and I know this all too well. They're really making wrapping this thing up a difficult task.
Outside and a full count, 3-2.
Well, no doubt in my mind, this has been the at-bat of the night so far.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. Here's a looping fly ball out to right. Gwynn moving to his left. He's got it, and there are two down now. Now at the plate, Lewis Basic, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Got him swinging in the dirt. And the throw will be in time as they'll wind up stranding the possible tying run at third base. And this ball game is over.
Wow, that's one of the best finishes we've been part of in a while. Two outs, tying run at third, the go-ahead run at first, but they can't find a way to get him home. Tough way to lose, but a great way to win a game.
Thank you. this one. Definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score. Sometimes that defining moment of the game is the ending. He came in and erased any hope the opposition may have had. And for that, he's our top player of the game.
Yeah, it's awfully comforting to have a guy like this you can call on to shut the door for you. He went out there and put the hammer down, and sometimes that's easier said than done.
Close one tonight, 2-1 the final score. The Bees jump out to a 1-0 series lead. So that's a wrap here tonight. Harold Reynolds, Dan Plesac, Matt Vasgersian, thanking you for watching Major League Baseball on MLB Network. Have a great night.
Our final line score. First for the victorious Stingers. Two runs on three hits. One error. They left three men on base. For the Rivercats, one run, four hits, no errors. They left seven men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 37 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.